I keep my head high. I got my wings to carry me. I don't know freedom. I want my dreams to rescue me. I keep my faith strong. I ask the Lord to follow me. I've been unfaithful. I don't know why you call on me. This is my canvas. I'ma paint it how I want it, baby. Oh, this is my canvas. I'ma paint it how I want it, nigga. Fuck you, cause there is no right or wrong. Only a song. I like to write alone, be in my zone. Think back to Forest Hills, no perfect home. But the only thing like home I've ever known, until they snatched it from my mama and foreclosed her on a loan. I'm so sorry that.
Hey y'all, this is Planet Outfit. I'm Niaja, this is Smalls, and we're here with India Bryant.
Well, yeah. First, we want to thank you for coming out here and supporting us as we support you, nice man. And we appreciate it.
Appreciate it.
So. And let's get this segment started. So, with that being said, go ahead and tell them a little bit about, you know what I'm saying, you as a person, where you was raised, as far as who put the ball in your hand for one.
Well, I'm 20 years old. I'm from Goose Creek. I was born and raised there. I guess when I was around 8 or 9, just playing ball at my grandma's house over the summer with my older cousins, and I was the first girl born, so you know, just playing ball with them. My cousin Brandon McFadden, he definitely put the ball in my hand and taught me everything I know now. So
you mentioned you was the only girl. So I bet your older cousins had it hard on you, right?
Yeah, for sure. I couldn't, you know, nobody wanted their little cousin, their little girl cousin, following them around all day. So it was tough sometimes, but it made me tougher, and you know, now I'm able to handle situations better because of them, just being young and outcasted at times.
And that's off the court. So on the court, like, they used to push you around.
Yeah,
and
for sure, yeah. Because they wanted me to get off the court. Right, so they were doing everything they could to get me off the court. But, you know, little did they know it was helping me, you know, stay on the court for the long run.
And your cousin, you said Brandon
McFadden? Yeah.
And he plays sports?
Nah, I actually haven't seen him in years.
For real?
Yeah, he's not really in my life anymore. I don't know really what happened, but, you know, just kind of, he got older, I got older.
So, high school, like, in high school, you say you graduated 2012?
Yeah, 2012.
Okay. So you're a junior in college right now?
Yes, sir.
All right, so how's that going?
It's going good. I mean, college has its ups and downs, playing ball and stuff like that, but for the most part, you know, I enjoy it, and just trying to win and graduate.
Right.
My thing
out. And going back to high school, like, did y'all go to the state or anything like that?
Yeah, we went state my sophomore year, and we went back my junior year, so we went back-to-back, and we lost my senior year in the lower state finals, so it was cool, but we won our first school state championship ever, so that was a pretty cool experience.
So the year y'all won, how much you average?
Probably like 12, maybe. You know, I ain't never been no big number type of player.
Yeah, all about the team type thing. All right. So, taking that big step to, you know, college and just seeing a whole new, like, livelihood, you know what I'm saying? How's that? How's the transition from high school, small little high school, to a big university?
Right? Well, freshman year was definitely probably one of the hardest years of my life, on and off the court. But luckily, I had teammates that cared about me and, you know, came where I came from, so. They helped me with that transition, but I mean, it had its tough days, and you know, still dealing with those tough days as a junior, but you know, it's life.
So I know, like, I went to college too, man. I knew how it was coming in as a freshman.
Right.
And how, like, the upperclassmen used to, nice saying, basically kind of bully you.
For sure.
But not in a bad way, but like, just to, nice saying, get you on your toes, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you had, like, what's his name, Brandon McFadden?
Yeah.
You had, like, a Brandon McFadden at college?
Pretty much, when I came in as a freshman, at least four of our starting five that year went to WBA or played overseas ball. So coming in as a freshman, I was playing against some big competition that were, you know, league ready. So it was tough, but it definitely, you know, helped me to grow.
That's what's up. So who would you say is the most competitive on your team and that you played against?
I would probably say Zelina McDaniels. She's our starting forward. She'll probably go into the league in another 2 years, and definitely one of my best friends, but she don't like to lose. And she definitely, we play hard because of her, and you know, she comes out with that fire every game. And I guess in high school, my own teammate, Lisa Welch, she played for USC, doing big things. She'll probably go into the league herself too, so you know, everybody play with her, she's trying to win.
So you mentioned both of these girls are going to the league. How do you feel about you? As yes, I know you don't really want to talk about it, but I had to ask you, right?
I mean, if the opportunity, you know, presents itself, I'll definitely take it, but I'm just taking it one day at a time, hoping for the best.
So how do you feel about Planet Outfit, like what we got going on and everything?
Well, I looked at the blog site a couple times, and I feel like it's great that, you know, there's people out here in Charleston that care and want to help out and get the talent seen and heard, so I think it's a great thing, and definitely a homie, so support all the way.
That's what's up, man. So let's get to know India, like behind the scenes type, you know what I'm saying? Because I think everybody know about you balling and everything like that.
Right.
But we want to know, like, India Bryant behind the scenes. So, like, what's your favorite food?
I like macaroni.
Macaroni?
Yeah.
All right. How about your favorite team? Like, not favorite team, but favorite player. Like, you got somebody you look up to?
Women's definitely Diana Taurasi, my all-time favorite player ever. And Kobe Bryant, of course. That's my daddy.
Okay. So what's in your headphones like before the game? Like, when you bumping in the locker room?
Honestly, for me, to calm my nerves down before big games, I just listen to a lot of love songs. Slow songs, cause
yo, that's rare.
You know, I get my nerves down, just calm my head down. You know?
So you be on the court singing your blues.
Basically.
That's what's up, man.
Basically.
What's up, man? But I mean, whenever you want to get this one-on-one,
listen,
you know what I mean?
I'm always ready.
I got a little hoop with me,
I'm always
though.
Ready to
I'm just
hoop.
Saying. The hoop man left me.
I'm
going
to have to hurt you.
Right, we're going to see, though. We're going to see. But that's about it, for real. Appreciate it for coming up.
For sure.
I mean,
I appreciate
you
it.
We're going to try to come catch a couple games, too, man.
Thank you.
But Young Smalls, Miss Bryant, and a beautiful night.
You there to deal with that alone. I was up in New York City chasing panties, getting done. Had no clue what you was going through. How could you be so strong? And how could I be so selfish? I know I could be so selfish. I could tell by how I treat you and my girl. Damn, she's so selfless, but she put up with my ways because she love me like you do. And no, it don't always show. I love her just like I love you. And I need to treat you better. Wish you could live forever. We can spend more time together. I love you, mama. I keep my head high. I got my wings.